We spent a whole lot of time lately talking about plastic guns like the Glock and the XD, but today we're bringing out the heavy metal. John Moses Browning's absolute classic, the 1911 45. Hooah! Thanks for joining us on Shoot of the Series. My name's Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training, and we want to thank all of our viewers for tuning in. We appreciate the traction that you're helping us get, and if you haven't already, hit the like, hit the share, hit the subscribe, but also hit that little bell for instant notifications. And every time we get a new video, you'll be sure to be one of the first to see it. Anyway, today we wanted to spend a little bit of time talking about the 1911, and as far as I'm concerned, what's not to like. Now, just like we always do, we're going to start by showing safe and clear. No big surprises, no accidents. We can have a nice conversation here. Now, what we're looking at here is a piece of technology that's over 100 years old. This was actually adopted by the military in 1911 and was carried by all the services until the early 80s, and now it's carried by different specialized groups within the military. So well over 100 years, and they're still using this design. Now, keep in mind that when this came out in 1911, there was a whole different sensibility about firearms, and it was up to the soldier to be able to master this pistol, follow directions, and use the instructions to make sure that they operated this in the safest way possible. But keep in mind that people were a lot different in 1911 than they were now. People are going to say that the 1911 is obsolete, and I say no. It has a lot of great safety features that are built into it. So, the most obvious is it has a frame-mounted safety. This is ambidextrous. You can see this. Up and down, up and down. If the safety's up, safety's on. Safety's down, safety is off. That's the first safety. You also have the grip safety. This has to be completely depressed or the hammer won't go. I don't care how strong you are. If this is not depressed, this hammer's a no-go. This has to be get a good, full, strong grip before that hammer is gonna go. Now, so safety number one, safety number two. It also has what's called a half cock. I'll show you that again. Half cock, that's also considered a safety, meaning it can't go forward. You don't wanna rely on a half cock though. Now the other safety it has is built into the muzzle itself. What I want to illustrate here is that there is something known as locking lugs that lock the barrel into the place, which means if the gun is pressed up against something, it cannot fire. What it does is when the locking lugs are engaged or disengaged by pressing it, this cannot fire. So if it's pressed up against something, the locking lugs disengage and that acts as a safety. All right. So, once again, different safeties. We talked about the muzzle safety. We talked about the grip safety. We talked about the frame-mounted safety. And we also talked about the half-cock position. Okay, now, when this gun was designed, John Browning meant for this gun to be carried in condition one, meaning with the hammer all the way to the rear and the safety up. So you carried this gun what's known as locked and cocked. Locked, meaning you've got the safety on, hammer back, and you've got a round in the chamber. This is meant how it was designed and meant to be carried. So you'd carry it live. You would have to flick the safety off when you're ready to fire. Now, this is what's known as in condition one, and that's the safest way to carry one of these. Now, you could also keep in mind that the safety will only engage when the hammer is all the way to the rear. Now, condition two would be carried a live round in the chamber, but in half cock. I don't consider that to be safe. More importantly, you don't really get a good engagement with that. More importantly, if you have to draw it and use it, you still have to pull this all the way back to use it. So, I'm not a big fan of carrying in condition two. Condition three would be that when you pulled the pistol, it wouldn't have a round in the chamber, and you would have to actually rack the slide before you went to work with it. So condition one, hammer's locked and cocked all the way to the rear. Flick the safety off, you're ready to fire. Condition two is carried in half cock, which I wouldn't recommend. Now, 1911 is a great gun, but keep in mind it is a 100 and something year old design. If you're going to carry a 1911 locked and cocked, my recommendation to you is that you carry it in a holster that you guys already know I like, called a thumb break. And what the thumb break allows you to do is everything is completely covered, but this particular strap acts as another safety. Even if all of the other safeties fail, you still have this strap of leather that interrupts the hammer from ever touching the firing pin. So if you want to carry a 1911 in the safest possible manner, you carry it locked and cocked, but with a thumb break. Now, some people may disagree. What I'm trying to do is side with the safest way possible. You're going to see other people that carry a 1911 different ways. I'm just trying to give you the safest way possible to shoot it. So what we're going to do now is when we come back, you're going to see me run a few rounds through it. So stick around. On behalf of Shoot of the Series, we want to thank you all for watching and tuning in. If you really like what we're doing, come find us on Patreon and consider partnering up with us. All right, we're back. So we've got the 1911 here and wanted to show you another product. This is a 10-round magazine they call a California Special made by Chip McCormick. And this is a fantastic manufacturer. It's got an extended base plate, which means you can carry an extra two and get the full complement of what California allows to carry. So, once again, finger on the top round, slide it in, give it a tap, rack the slide, let it slam forward. That's a lot of fun. All right. Well, that concludes our little chat about the 1911, the various conditions, and my recommendation, you carry it locked and cocked with a thumb break. Anyway, we want to thank you all for joining us on Shoot of the Series. My name's Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training. Y'all take care.